Don't touch your dial.
Keep it right where it's at. There's something big coming up on your screen.
Just settle back and relax, 'cause you're gonna get a whole lot of singing, a whole lot of laughing, a whole lot of loving from me.
Beautiful. When I got up this morning, I thought I had a chest cold. I called my doctor and he said, I'd feel better when the ice cubes melt. Yeah, I'm gonna take myself a little vacation after the show tonight. This year, I wanna travel and go to places I have never been before, like Tahiti or South America or my bedroom. Let's remember now, you got in for nothing. Oh, I might go to Palm Springs. I like it there. The nights are so clear, you can reach out and grab a star. I tried it once, and Raquel Welch slapped me. Just plain old slapped me. Last year, my genie and I, we took a motor trip, and we had a wreck in the car. My mother-in-law. That they like. We drove up to the Dakotas. You need four sheets for those letters? We drove up to the Dakotas and saw Mount Rushmore. That was really something. Abraham Lincoln, George Washington, Thomas Jefferson, and Teddy Roosevelt. Now, those are my kind of presidents. Two of them were stoned and the other two were on the rocks.
That your door is always open and your path is free to walk. That makes me tend to leave my sleeping bag rolled up and stashed behind your couch. Well, it's knowing I'm not shackled by forgotten words and bonds and the ink stains that have dried upon some lime. Keeps you in the river, my memory keeps you on my mind. Oh, it's not clinging to the rocks and ivy planted on their columns, now they're buying me. Or something that somebody said because they thought we fit together walking. It's knowing that the world will not be cursing or forgiven when I walk along some railroad track and find that you're moving on the back roads by the rivers of my memory, and for hours you're just gentle on the mind. Back from the gurgling tracks up in some train yard. My beard a rough and cold pile and a dirty hat pulled across my face. Two cup hands round a tin can, I pretend I hold you to my breast and find that you're waving from the back roof by the river of my memory, ever smiling, ever gentle on my mind. That's all right. Power.
Gentle on my mind. Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, this kid's got a beautiful throat. Every time he shows his uvula, women faint. No, that's that thing that hangs down. That's a uvula. Well, I'm gonna tell you, you're a good audience, and you should have a lot of fun tonight, because before the show, I poured some scotch into the air conditioning.
We generally taped on a Sunday. Let me give you Dean's schedule. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, he played golf. Saturday afternoon, on his way home from the golf course, in his car was a cassette of the songs that he was going to sing with guests. On Sunday, he showed up at noon. He went through the music rehearsal with the orchestra. At 1 o'clock, we took a break for lunch. At 2 o'clock, we went through the show with me doing Dean. Not singing, because I sing off key. Another guy do the singing. He sang on key. Dean watched it in his dressing room. In between that, he was watching professional football. I'd go back in the dressing room, take him out, bring him on the stage. He'd look at it, see where the cue cards were. He'd kind of walk through some of it. We left the punchlines off the cue cards. That was part of the fun, placing him in a little corner and seeing how he's going to get out of it. I trusted him to get out of it because I knew his capabilities. I knew him well. I knew him better than I knew this hand. And loved him just as much.
Huh? Got you the date, huh? We're all set. Ah. Now we're gonna go? Okay.
Do it tonight,
huh?
Yeah.
Do it upright?
That's right.
How are you girls doing back there?
Fine, Harry.
That's good.
Ramona! What are you doing?
Oh, a compliment to your song. I'm your orchestration, you know.
I forget the orchestra compliment.
Okay.
This is the first time I'm out with these girls. Let's try to make them, you know, a nice impression on them.
Okay, okay. You say, all right.
Good. Look, I told them, the girls, you know, we'd take them to downtown for a big meal, you know, and a big show, you know, downtown. Mm-hmm. But this is Saturday night, you know, and everything is going to be double. So it's going to cost us at least $6 or $7 a piece, you know what I mean?
At least, yes.
So I figured before we hit the toll bridge, you know, we could make the cutoff. And we go into a drive-in, you know what I mean?
Good idea.
You know, so we go into a drive-in, we see a movie, and there's a hot dog and pizza stand, and we let them eat, you know?
Oh, yeah, turn them loose.
Sure. $4 for big men.
For big men, $4.
Yes. I'll break it to them.
Go ahead.
Listen, girls.
We're not going to any drive-in movie.
Gee, how'd you know that?
I know the way your mind works. You're cheap.
That's right.
I thought you said we were going downtown to a nice restaurant and a big show, and now we wind up at a drive-in movie.
Oh, Helen, you really have to look at it from a boy's point of view. It is hard to get into town on a Saturday night, and it's expensive.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
Yeah, and after all, they are handsome, and they are single, and they are cheap.
See, I told you, the regular girls, right?
Regular.
Okay, so you want to park here? Is it too far back for you?
No, that's okay.
Is it okay for you?
It's
okay for you, fine.
Fine, okay.
All right, then we'll put it right up here.
That's good. Hey, we're lucky that the picture is ready to begin.
Ah, good.
Okay.
What are you doing? Just sprucing up.
Why sprucing up? What do you mean sprucing up?
Sprucing up. You're gonna be a little sprucy, you know what I mean? Look, why don't you go and get in the back?
What for?
You gotta be kidding. Look, will you just go on, just sit in the back, huh?
Why should I get in the back? I can see perfect right where I am here. Good night. Everything's clean.
Look, you can see just as well in the back as you can hail up here, will you? Will you just go sit in the back?
I can't sit back there. There are two girls back there.
Look, why don't you just go and sit in the back? That'll force one of the girls to come up and sit in the front. Understand? Now, if you go in the back and sit in the back, you can sit in the back with one of the girls. and in the back seat, and I'll be sitting in the front seat with one of the girls in the front seat.
And?
And? I got a car, spent money for $4, and you give me an and? I'm sitting with an and.
Go sit in the front.
I don't want to sit in the front. You sit in the front. I want to sit back here.
Well, one of us has to sit in the front.
Why does one of us have to sit in the front?
Because one of us has to sit in the front. Doesn't look right, two fellas sitting in the front seat and two girls sitting in the back seat. Now you go sit in the front.
Why?
Why? Listen, I get you a date with two fellas and we get all dressed up and put hats on and everything, and then you give me a why. I'm sitting here with a why.
Look, don't ask any questions. Just go sit in the back, okay?
To go sit up front.
I don't want to sit in the front.
I said go sit in the front.
No.
Go sit in the front.
Why? What are you sitting up front for?
Somebody told me to come sit in the front.
All right, let's stop kidding around here. You like him, I like you. Look, come on, let's sit in the front. Well, you... What's the matter? Don't you like me? All right. Everybody out of the car. Okay, Helen, you sit up there in the back. Joe, you come up. Joyce, you come follow me. Dan, you sit in the back. Okay, come on, let's go. That's all. Is this it? This is it.
Boy, what a personality he's got. He may look stupid, but boy, he acts fast.
What are you doing?
Scratch my finger getting out of the front seat in the back here. That's why I thought I'd do this.
Well, don't do that, all right? What do you want?
I wanted some Band-Aid, and that's for my finger.
You got a little tiny scratch. What do you whine about that? You'll be all right. Just take it easy.
Boy, he's a real hypochondriac.
Little cut. Will you cut?
I think it's a little drafty in here.
Oh, I begin to get your draft.
I think it's a little strange here.
Well, it was the wind, sweetheart.
What?
Turn the radio off. I'm trying to hear them.
That's not the radio. That's my thing. It's leaving my hand.
Oh.
You're turning it around.
Oh, poor little finger.
It's nothing. It's just the fingernails are on the wrong side. Now, that's all.
Poor little finger.
William! What do you want to
push the lighter in?
Lighter he wants. Here. Here. Mm.
If the four of us ever go out together again, don't take him along.
Yeah.
Get your lighter back.
I'm on fire!
Well, I bleed around and plead around this old town too long. Well, summer's almost gone. Yes, the winter's coming on. Well, I've bleed around and I've played around this old town too long. And I feel just like I've got to travel on. I bought the rights to Johnny, but Johnny can't come home. I know Johnny can't come home. I said my Johnny can't come home. Well, Papa writes to Johnny, but Johnny can't come home, 'cause he's been on that chain gang too long. Well, I want to see my baby. Well, I want to see her bad. Well, I want to see her bad. Oh, I gotta see her bad. Well, I want to see my baby. Well, I want to see her bad, 'cause she's the best gal this poor boy ever had. Well, I played around and I played around this old town too long. Well, summer's almost gone, yes, and the winter's coming on. Well, I've laid around and I've played around this old town too long, and I feel just like I've got to travel on. Well, the high sheriff and the police, well, they're riding after me. Well, they're riding after me, oh, they're riding after me. Well, the high sheriff and the police, well, they're riding after me, and I feel just like I've got to travel on. Well, I said I've laid around and I've played around this old town too long, and I feel just like I've got to travel on.
Oh, that was great. You sing so sweet that my face breaks out just listening to you.
Ah.
Then how do you manage to stay so wholesome and clean-cut?
Well, I have a woman come in twice a week.
She sure does a great job of polishing your cheeks. But no, kidding, you got a great image going for you. 50 million women see you as the boy next door, and they all love you.
Well, no wonder I'm so tired, trying to answer all that fan mail.
You know, actually, our images aren't all that different.
Really? You mean that the women see you as the boy next door?
No, as the man peeking through the window.
Hey, we sound like a great team. Why don't we sing something?
Hit it, Les. We mustn't keep Glenn up past his bedtime. What is it?
Oh, yeah.
It's been a blue, blue day. I feel like running away. I feel like running away from it all. My love has been untrue. She found somebody new. It's been a blue, blue day. Like crying, crying, dying, dying. What can I do? I feel like praying, praying, saying, saying. Well, I'm glad we're through.
Well, I never felt more like singing the blues, 'cause I never thought that I'd ever lose your love, dear. Why'd you do me this way?
Oh, I never felt more like crying all night, 'cause everything's wrong and nothing ain't right without you. You got me singing the blues.
Well, the moon and the stars no longer shine. The dream is gone I thought was mine. There's nothing left for me to do. Cry over you. You'll never know, dear, how much I loved you. Please don't take sunshine away.
The other night, dear, as I lay sleeping, I dreamed I held you in my arms.
Must have been a nightmare. But when I woke, dear, I was mistaken. So I just hung down my little bitty head.
Walter Stone, and I'm with the National Broadcasting Company. We're doing a survey on senior citizens. You don't mind answering a few questions, do you?
Oh, I just wanted to... There. People think I feed squirrels. I'm feeding kitty. Feeding the kitty nuts. Yes. Why, what did you ask me? This isn't a book about sex, is it?
Oh, no, no.
I'm not a talker. I'm a doer.
ask your name?
Certainly, my name's Isaac Boothcourt. I'm 91 years old, and I was born in Wickardville, Ohio. Want to sit down?
Yes. You're in pretty good shape for a 91-year-old man. To what do you attribute your longevity?
Well, I can't die. See, we ain't got no funeral home. Oh, Jeff Beeson passed away here last summer. There was three prairie dogs, four to be exact. Pretty good size ones. Dragged him out to the outskirts of town. Buried him in a gopher hole. All six of them. I watched him. Stuff took about better than 6 hours to stuff him down that hole.
I see that that Civil War cannon back
where
there.
Where do you see it?
See it here in history?
Oh, yeah, oh, yeah.
History.
Back in there.
Yeah.
That's a long way back there. Yeah. Yeah. Ben's, I ain't got no glasses. I can't see that far. I can hardly make you out.
Yeah.
You are a fella, ain't you?
Yeah, I am. History really left its mark on this town, didn't it?
It sure did, I tell you. Betsy Ross bit me right here.
She gave you a hickey?
She certainly did. Yeah, she gave me a good little bite there. She was the woman that made the flag, you know, put a little stars in the thing. Oh, yeah, and then there was Brigham Young once whipped me in the back. Remember him? George Washington slept right here, incidentally. He had to chase a wino off to do it. A little history. I wouldn't tell you otherwise.
I see. I see you got a woman in this town running for...
Oh, yeah. Yeah, when you get to be this age, a lot of them things come on you all of a sudden.
See, you got a...
Huh?
I see you got a woman in this town running for mayor. Well, what do you think of a woman in politics?
Well, I tell you something. Mr. Stone, is that it?
Stoning.
I'd be... You know, I think I see... Oh, I guess not. At any rate, I just don't want any part of women, period. I've been married 5 times, and every one of them women run off with my hired hand. Now, here past summer, I caught the last missus with a hired hand. They was out in my melon patch. You know what they'd done? They hollered out. I caught them inside. They'd hollered out a watermelon. And they was making love in that hollered out watermelon. Just kissing up a storm. Well, I caught them, though. You know what I did?
What?
I had my little Instamatic with me. I took a picture of them. Oh, yeah. Sent it for the centerfold in the seed catalog.
Let's take a little vacation. Let's take a plane to St. Paul. Let's take a kayak to Quincy or Nyack. Let's get away from it all. Let's find a faraway island where life's little problems are small. And each local native is cooperative. Let's get away from it all.
Hey, there's the place now. Yeah, that's the place, Victor.
That's the place?
Yeah.
It's like a very exotic country.
Yeah, now before we land, I think I should warn you. They have a strange custom here. Mm-hmm. Yes, they do. Whenever you stay overnight in a man's home, he will offer to share his wife with you. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Now, you must accept, or otherwise he'll be very insulted. Now, this is how they show their hospitality in this land.
Say, I think I'm going to have a wonderful time here in Beverly Hills.
Well, I've been here in Alaska for 2 weeks now, and that's the prettiest girl I've seen yet. Who's she?
Oh, that's a lady of the evening. And if you'd like to date her, it'll cost you $6,000.
$6,000 for a lady of the evening?
Well, don't forget, up here, the nights are 6 months long. Buongiorno.
What was that?
Come pass.
What?
Come pass, buongiorno.
Oh, you're Danish.
Gentlemen, we will have pate foie gras with truffles. Mm-hmm. Truffles. Monsieur Zouaz, do you like fish? pheasant on the glass.
Jawohl, glass.
Chateaubriand, very rare, and rare. And instead of... What are you looking at? Oh, me. Béarnaise sauce. Do you like béarnaise? Well, I'd rather have the escoffier sauce. I don't like
it. Escoffier?
Oh, escoffier, yeah. Well, one escoffier and one escoffier. Mm-hmm. One bottle of little wine. One bottle of Chateau Lafitte, 1959. That's a very good price. And for dessert, let's have Cherry's Jubilee. I love Cherry's Jubilee. Yeah, please.
When?
Yeah. And? Yo! One number four!
Well, there's the fifth helmet. There's your elephant gun. And let's see. Oh, you need some shells. About 6 boxes of shells. And your Bowie knife. There you are. And, oh, may I ask, I do hope you have a nice vacation. By the way, where are you going?
I'm going to visit my son at San Francisco State College.
My name is Naomi.
My name is Richard.
You're very handsome.
Thank you.
You know, I think I'm falling in love.
Thank you.
Well, I'll only be here one weekend.
Well, I'm dancing as fast as I can.
No! Wouldn't it just be wonderful if we had nothing to do all year but play golf?
Yeah, sure is a great game.
Yeah. Mr.
Fenton. Huh?
Mr. Fenton, your wife has just been taken to the hospital. She's having her baby.
Oh, hey, I gotta hurry. Excuse me, mind if I play through? Oh, fine.
Hello, Doctor.
Oh,
I'm going to South America for my vacation. Do I need any inoculations?
Oh, yes, you do. You just step in the inner office and remove all your clothes, and I'll be with you in a minute.
A Miss Howard to see you, Doctor.
I beg your grace?
A Miss Howard?
Oh, yes.
Hello, Doctor.
Howdy.
I'm going to South America for my vacation. Do I need any inoculation shots?
Nah, you'll be all right. Senores and senoritas, this is your captain speaking. Welcome to Cuban Airlines, flight number 16. Aha. Hey, we are happy to announce that the flight surrender battalion de Carazon Diete, Casi para Cazoca to me, baby Canole, Sleepy Seeds, will be arriving at Havana Airport, Havana 615 Airport.
Okay, take this airplane to Miami.
Where? Oh, this way.
Yes.
And where do you come from?
Oh, I've just come back from Veracruz, Mexico.
From what's her name?
Veracruz.
Veracruz. Oh, Veracruz. Yes. Oh, it isn't.
Yes.
Do you have anything?
Oh, no, officer, no.
You need a little laundry here. Oh, this is an interesting thing. I'm sorry.
That face was over 2,000 years old.
Gee, what a relief. I thought it was new.
It's okay, I'll carry you.
Oh, goody.
On second thought, I'll carry the parrot. You carry the girl.
Are you kidding? Well, she must weigh 400 pounds. How are we going to get her out of here?
Well, I guess we'll just have to make 2 trips. Hey, we're going to move her. We need help.
That's a good idea. I'll call the auto club.
Now, we got to carry her.
I'll get a stretcher.
Okie dokie. Now, don't you worry, lady. We'll have you out of here in no time.
Well, you better hurry. This fire is terrible.
Lie down there.
I
lie
can't.
Down. Oh, come on, lie down.
I can't, not with my leg.
Hey, lie down without her.
Hey, no. I'll tell you what, you gotta get behind her, and she'll lean all of her weight on you, and then you slowly lower her to the ground. And what are you gonna do?
I'll notify your next of kin. I know how to get her down. I'll take her a box of chocolates. I have a feeling she'll follow him anywhere.
Okay.
Excuse me, lady. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go.
Down, down. How you got it, baby? Get down. Easy.
Prove to be kind sometimes.
Sure.
All right, get a hold of her, Dean.
Okay.
Right there, right there. Now, when I say three, let's lift.
Okay.
One, two, three, lift. We're going to have to get her up on her feet again. Now, you would figure that anything this big would have a handle on it.
Yeah. I got a funny feeling that it ain't going to work.
I tell you what. Huh? You get in front of her, and you pull.
Uh-huh.
And I'll walk around behind her.
Oh, you walk around while I pull, huh?
Right.
Say, see if you can find a shortcut. We can go all day around.
Right. Right. Or just pull on her arms, Dean. Pull!
I'm killing myself here. How about a little help?
You just pull on your end, and my end will follow. Pull! Wait a minute. Wait a minute. I got a better idea. Come here. Come here, Dean. Look. She's got a broken leg, right? Why don't we just shoot her?
Good. Where are we gonna find a harpoon?
Yeah, right. You got a point there. You sure got a point. Come on, I'll pull and you push. Come on, lady. Now push, Dean.
Dean Martin Variety Show, after the second year that it was on the air and for the next 8 years, was among the top 10 shows on the network, because what you were watching was a guy who was cute, delightful, charming, funny, and wonderful to sit back and just say, hey, he looks like a really nice guy. He looks like he's having a good time. And my watching Dean perform made me feel the same way. I was having a good time watching Dean. I had a smile on my face every time he performed. I'd sit there like this, looking like a Buddha, going, hey, that's great. And that's what he was. He was, when you look at him, just look at his moves. Look at the way he adjusts his tie. Look at the way he works his head, the way he works his hands. He'll have a cigarette in his hand from time to time. And the way he works with performers. He doesn't work to the camera when he's working with a guest, when he's working with Petula Clark, and there's that great chemistry, and you feel that he's having a good time. He's singing to her. He's not singing to a camera for a close-up. He's got the job. He doesn't have to prove himself.
I'm no millionaire.
Yes, you are.
But I'm not the type to care, 'cause I've
got a pocket full of dreams. Even with an empty purse,
'cause I've
got a pocket full of dreams.
Well, all I do is dream of you the whole night through.
With the dawn I still go on and I dream of you.
You're every thought, you're everything, you're every song I ever sing.
Four hours a day. Let be spent in sweet content. Dream away.
Skies are gray, skies are blue. Morning, noon, and nighttime too. All I do the whole day through is dream of you. Dream when you're feeling blue.
That's the thing to do.
Just watch the smoke rings rise in the air. You'll find your share of memories there.
So dream. Sunshine peeps through. There's only one thing to do.
That's a wrap your troubles in dreams. Dream your troubles away.
Your castles make problems that's fate after all. Life's really funny that way.
No use to grumble, just smile as they fall. Weren't you queen for a day?
Uh-huh. Just remember the sunshine.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. It is nice to be greeted by all that warmth, love, and affection. Of course, I get that at home from my wife, but it means a lot more coming from you. If you decide you're not happy with me, you don't get half of what I own. I think it's interesting to watch the changes that are going on in TV, especially in the area of censorship. I mean, when you can turn on just about any channel and see gorgeous girls jumping up and down in tight T-shirts, you know that things are loosening up. I guess you've noticed that while you're eating your dinner at a TV tray, you can switch on the set and see practically nude women all over the place. Of course, if your TV set is broken, you don't have to miss one of those shows. You just eat your dinner and put a wet T-shirt over your Jell-O. I think you know the kind of shows I'm talking about. The shows the network executives call the jiggle shows. They're shows that bounce their way into your house every night of the week. Here's a show that was so popular it ran for 5 years, called Charlie's Angels. In this particular episode, according to TV listing, the disappearance of a congressman's daughter caps a wave of violence on secluded Hawaiian beaches. Well, now, that guy who wrote that show really knew what he was doing. I mean, you put three girls in bikinis chasing criminals along a beach, and you got a winner. Now, the hot sand is a stroke of genius. I mean, that's got to keep them jumping. If you watch TV long enough, you're going to see more navels than if you work for Sunkist. Let's see, on another... Here's a show they could never have done a few years ago, Three's Company. It's an interesting show. John Ritter plays a kind of boob, and the other two boobs on the show made Suzanne Somers a star. obviously, these shows are after ratings, and pretty girls with practically nothing on seems to get them. Personally, I think all of this flaunting of sex on television is disgusting. I think a person can have a successful show without appealing to man's baser instincts. That's why I would like to read you a poem, a lovely poem, by Joyce Kilmer. It is called Trees. I think that I shall never see a poem lovely as a tree. A tree that may in summer wear a nest of robins in its hair. A tree whose hungry mouth is pressed against the earth's sweet flowing breast.
People in their 20s who were not even born at the time the show was on the air, they look at Dean and they go, "Hey, man, cool." Now, that's a word we never used 25, 30 years ago, but it works today. And you look at Dean and you go, "Cool." That's what he was. He was way, way, way ahead of his time.
I can't begin to tell you, 'cause your husband's listening in.
What do you think my buddy Ken got me for Christmas? A color TV set that cost him $49. Now, every Monday I watch Green Skelton.
We could make believe we're nudists.
Gonna go to the cow shop. Before I go, remember the famous words of Herbert Hoover, who once said, "Show me a man who gets up with the roosters, and I'll show you a sex maniac."
Jimmy, good morning!
You know something, Dean?
What?
You know, Dean, this being my New Year's Eve, I thought it only fitting that you and me make our New Year's resolutions together. Now, repeat after me. I promise to stop drinking.
I promise to stop drinking.
I promise to stop smoking.
I promise to stop smoking.
I promise to stop chasing women.
I promise to stop chasing women.
Okay, Dean, let's go out and celebrate. The booze and the girls are waiting in the car.
But, Jimmy, what about our New Year's resolution?
Oh, that ain't for New Year's 1971. It's for New Year's 1991. But then it won't be a resolution. It'll be a necessity.
Yeah. Party with Jimmy last year. He blew a horn for 10 minutes before he found out it was his nose.
Fairy tales can come true. It can happen to you if you're young at heart. For it's hard, you will find, to be an arrow of mind if you're young at heart. You can go to extremes with impossible schemes. You can laugh when your dreams fall apart at the seams. And life gets more exciting with each passing day. Love is either in your heart or on its way. Don't you know that it's worth every treasure on earth to be young? much better by far to be young. And if you should survive to 105, look at all you'll derive out of being alive. And here is the best part: you had a head start. If you are among
to bed.
Jeeves?
Ladies and gentlemen, we are very pleased to have with us tonight Jack Benny's favorite tenor, the very, very wonderful Dennis Day.
Ah, the drums go banging, the cymbals clang, and the horns, they dance away. The carby pumps, the old bassoon, and I, the pipes to play. Ah, Hennessy, Hennessy, pipes to prune, and me on the crowd, the brand. I cut it to old Ireland, and back to that and
Mr. Elvis Presley.
Thank you.
Baby left me. Well, I found a new place to dwell.
Oh. No wonder he does that. That feels good.
Feels good. Well, it's down at the end of Lonely Street. That's what we can tell.
If I didn't care,
honey, child, if I didn't care, now,
would it be the same?
Honey, would it ever be the same?
Would my every prayer begin and end with just your name?
Just your lousy little name, honey, child.
And would I be sure this is love beyond compare?
Did it hurt you?
True. If I didn't care,
lay it on me, honey child.
And now let's go back to those wonderful Warner Brothers musical days of the 1930s and meet Dick Powell and Ruby Keeler.
Star.
us out tonight. I don't know if it's cloudy or bright, 'cause I only have eyes for you. Yes, I only have eyes for you.
Gee, Dick, that was swell!
Since you was about that high. Now you're high all the time.
Yes.
you shouldn't be doing that. You know, I remember when you was a kid. Seeing you smoke now reminds me. You was about 8 years old. Used to get that stuff up in the trees. I don't know what it was. They said it was corn silk. Then you'd run around back and go, right? Remember?
Yes,
I remember. Oh, gosh, and I'd have to spank you for that, didn't I? Yes. Listen. This is something that the kids made in shop class for you. It's a big olive is what it is. And if you fall in the snow, see, this is the pimento. And you just put that around your neck or whatever you want to put it around. Isn't that sweet?
Oh, that's
the boy, lovely. The boys in the shop class made that for you.
That's real sweet, Ma.
You know, can we go over here? Who's that?
That's Kenneth Lane.
Hi, Kenny.
Hello, Ma.
You know, I watch you every... Watch you when Dean jumps up. Sit on the piano, sweetheart. Gosh, I can't get over you. What happened to you? You blew it.
Yeah, I said it was going to be something. Gosh. I just blew the whole
well,
thing.
Well, you know, I'll never forget this. So many. Kenny, are you interested in this?
Yes.
I hope so. Otherwise, I'll sink one to you. Are these all yours? In the back there look like they might be dog teeth. My third mister had dog teeth. Oh, yeah, he was weird. Yeah, I shot him. Oh, yeah, well, at any rate, would you sing me a little song?
Oh, I'll just play something, Kenny.
Romantic.
Oh, sure.
Oh, that's sweet. He plays good.
Thank you.
Your hands are so delicate.
Thank you.
Did you stay indoors a lot? You didn't get out to play a lot, did you? But now you can.
Oh. Oh. Embrace me, my sweet embraceable you. Embrace me, you irreplaceable you.
Oh, Dean, my corrective shoes. And my stockings just went round three times.
Just one look at you, my heart grew tipsy in me.
That's the sound of a heart.
Hear it?
That's a better heart. Take me to the house of pies. We'll have a tall iced tea and just...
You and you alone bring out the gypsy in me.
What you brought out in me? My hearing aid, I hear you now. You're coming in real good. Them wires was crossed when I got off the bus. Sing it again, Dean, whatever.
I love all the many charms about you. Oh. Above all, I want my arms about you.
You know, I'd like to make love to you in a tractor tire. just the two of us in there. Ain't that a picture, Deanie?
Yes.
Don't be a naughty baby. Come to Papa, come to Papa. Do.
Do what?
Do.
Do.
Come to Papa, do.
Oh, you make me feel warm all over my body. My panty girdle is melting.
My sweet embraceable.
My brooch is. Where is my brooch? Goodbye, Kenny.
Goodbye, Maud.
Bless your heart. What is that note you left in my hand? See you down at the funeral home? What a strange place to meet. Oh, you're something else. Deanie, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Bing Crosby was another guest that we had on the show quite a few times, and Dean really enjoyed working with Bing. Like, he felt comfortable with Frank. He felt very comfortable with Bing. And Bing was really a nice guy. And we had a lot of fun together, you know.
Toot, toot, say goodbye. Toot, 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 say don't cry. That choo-choo train that takes me away from you. Nobody knows how sad it makes me. Kiss me, Tootsie, and then do it over again. I want you to watch for the mail. I'm not gonna fail. If you don't get a letter, then you know I can't write. Tootsie, goodbye. Tootsie, goodbye. There'll be no heebie-jeebies hanging around. So keep on hollering so the world will know. Here I go, I'm Alabama bound. Swanee, how I love you, how I love you, my dear old Swanee. The folks up north will see me no more when I get to the Swanee door. Oh, April shower.
Oh, sing it, dear.
They bring a flower that's blue in May. So keep on looking for a blue.